Hi guys, this is Karen Sassine with Mosaic Mentoring, and I am working with Smalti today. I finally started the Asian Garden 2, and this is where I'm at, just to show you guys. So this is my setup. Let me back it up and show you. I've got my Asian Garden 1 up there, and here's the picture of, let me scroll out, there's the picture that I'm doing for the second one, and I'm starting. So I've got my iPad set up, makes it kind of nice to work with, and that's where I'm working. So this is my setup. This is a temporary setup. I've got my Hardy on a rolling cart because it's not the right height yet, so I'm still working out that the details on that. And I've got all my supplies back there, kind of based on color. And then I've got my tabletop Hardy, which I really am enjoying. That one's a little bit high though, so I'll play with that in a minute and show you. But it works. It's just, I actually use it mostly for nibbling. Let me get some thinset off of there. Sometimes I have to take a piece off and recut a piece, and the thinset gets on the Hardy. So this is my tray. I've got my tweezers and my little brush. I always use, I love to use this, the Italian spatula. And this is the little silicone containers that I mix my thin set in. I always have my water right there. I've got paper towels, and I usually have it damp a little bit. I'll just spritz some water on there. And then over here, I've got a lot of Smalti in little containers. I just makes it easier to have the little containers there. And then these little trays, I got these years ago, and oh my God, do I love them, because they're like they're by Rubbermaid, but they don't make them anymore. And they were the lids to all the containers that I used to use. And I cut off the little tab. So I stack them. And that's where I pull my colors from. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, let's see, let me flip this and put this here. And I'll just work for a little bit and show you what I'm doing. All right. So I'm really working with value. Trying to make pieces that fit into the space. So I'll take a little piece and I'll hold it over and visualize what it looks like. And then sometimes I use nippers and sometimes I use the hammer and Hardy. It just depends. There's really no set. I guess it depends on how hard the cut is, whether I use the nippers or the hammer and Hardy. Now this, where I've choked up here, that's nibbling. And I do that a lot when you have a piece that you just need to nibble a little bit off of. That's how I do it. I'm gonna check to see if it fits. It might be, it looks like it might be a little bit big. Yep. So I'm gonna nibble just a little bit off. Like there, I might have cut too much. We'll see. Nope, perfect. So now for the fun part. Squeeze really tightly, and you have to dip and get that perfect amount. So when I dip it and nothing sticks to it, that means it needs to be mixed. It's been sitting for a few minutes, and it starts to slake over. So you want that soft part on top. So when I dip the tile in, I get this nice peak. And that's what I'm looking for, is that perfect peak. And it's that fine line between just enough and not too much and not too little. And then how many of you guys loved the game Operation when you were a little kid, if you're my age or somewhere close to it? It was one of my favorite games when I was a kid. And putting this piece in is like playing the game Operation. And then I gently push down on it and seat it in. Let me take this off and I'll show you. Hold on. There we go. So this is the piece that I was putting in. And you could see there's a little bit of squish right here. So what I'm going to do, if I like to work really neatly, I get dragged away often. So almost with every piece, I'll take that little extra squish and get rid of it. And the reason why is because if I leave that there and get dragged off, when I come back, that squish is going to be rock hard, and it's going to make it hard to put the next piece in right next to it. So here's a prime example right here. So here's some squish that if I don't take that and cut it down while it's still wet, then I'll have to make sure that the next piece that I put next to it has this area that's cut out to accommodate that. And we don't want that. That's real hard to have to do each time. So I'm constantly making sure that I keep all the squish to a minimum. And this stuff's all pretty wet, so makes it easy to clean off. So that's my piece. Hey, Sunshine. How are you? What I'm going to do is I'm going to just keep working on the ferns for a little while. And the juniper, I guess, or whatever that is behind it. And then, you know, I could jump around. So I've got this rock right here. I might put that element in. I can go ahead and add the purple and then the green afterwards. I like working. I don't like working one section all the way across. I get bored with it. So, but you could see right here. Whoops, wait a minute. There we go. So this is the area that I'm working right now. And that's my interpretation of it. So bit by bit, I'm getting there. I do love to have this tabletop hardy, though. And the one that I got it from DMosaico. And I got this little extra, I don't know what this material is, but it's just soft enough where when you hit it, you get this nice little ping. Gives me an opportunity to do my nibbling without having to move over here to the log. Otherwise, I'd have to go back and forth and back and forth. So it's nice to have this right here next to me. What else? I'm working with a mixture of Italian and Mexican Smalti. So if you look at this, this is a piece of the Mexican Smalti. It's got modeling on the top of it and on the bottom. Modeling meaning it just like different colors. It's not a flat, flat color. Usually the top and the bottom are different colors on Mexican Smalti. Whereas a piece of Italian Smalti, the color is consistent through and through. And you've got the riven side, which is the inside, and that's the side that you, it's nice to use. It gives you, it gives you this, the light reflects off of it nicely. Whereas the top or the bottom side, it's pretty flat. And it's just not as, it's not as interesting to use. I like to use, for this piece, I like to use a mixture. So I'm going to point out some different things that I'm using. So this is Mexican, 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 Italian, Mexican cut down. Some of these are Italian, but some of them, like this one, I think, this is actually Mexican, and I sheared off the top of it to give it the nice reflection from the light. This one right here, this is a piece of Mexican, but I've also sheared off the top of it. I didn't do that in my last piece, so I'm kind of playing with that on this piece, learning a little bit as I go. Hey, Catherine, how are you? Wow, I feel honored. what else? So these are just cut out pieces, individual pieces that I cut in half first, and then I would take the hammer and hardy and I cut the points. These little areas in between, I'm just going to leave like they are. I could fill them in, or because I use enough thin set to fill in the area and you don't see the substrate, I'm going to leave them like they are. But, you know, there could be some areas where I would want to put just a little piece in there to give it an even darker value or a different value or color or whatever. And as you can see right here, I'm just going to keep this line coming down. So this is the edge of the juniper, I guess they're called, or what, I don't know what they're called, but, and I'll just bring that line down. Now, since I've wrapped the edges and my drawing doesn't really go over that, I could just take a pencil and there, you know, it's, I'm just going to draw my leaves in. So this is a leaf. It's going to come down, and then right here I'll do some more leaves and kind of make a leaf like that. And then on this side, and this is really rough. I'm not one of those super precise painterly Smalti artists. As you can see here, it's very representational. You know, I've got just different kinds of cuts to make different kinds of shapes. A lot of those pieces are full pieces, not cut at all. This piece was done back in 2008, and I did this piece just prior to going to Orsoni. I had won the trip to Orsoni through SAMA, and I had never worked with Smalti before, and I always wanted to. So I thought, okay, let me see where my abilities lie. So I tend to reach for high, lofty goals. So this is what I had done. And gosh, 10, 18, many years later, 19, 13 years later, I just decided it was time to do another one. And I want to see the difference between this one and the original one. So there's the one that I'm working on. It'll be neat. I'm using a lot more colors, a lot more different values. We'll see. I have no idea. It'll be fun. I'm excited. Excited to see it progress. And I will definitely post all the time, teach you guys what I'm doing. Oh, just to show you a little bit, another thing that I did. Let me turn that, flip this around. So my board is on an angle. And what I did, I had this piece of wood that, this is actually the piece of wood that I used to hammer in my hardy, to seed it in the log. So it was just hanging out at my studio. And I took tape and I taped it. I taped it far enough back so I can have this. I always have this long, skinny tray in front of me. I've got a few of them, and I love working with them. So I always have those. But I taped this here. And then back here, let me show you. So I've got these boxes of really heavy tiles. And it allowed me to angle my board up. But having that wood piece taped there, it doesn't slide. And this, if I want to make it more upright, I just push these in. And if I want it to drop down a little bit more, I'll just take that top box off. And this gives me the ability. People are always wondering how to create a... that angle so you can work with it up so you don't have to lean over. So So yeah, I like doing that. And now that I'm standing up, let me pan back a little bit, just show you my area. The other thing that I found this at Goodwill once, these carts, and I love them. Just gives me more working space to keep all my crap. So that's it. What else? There's my thin set. I pre-mix it, neutral gray, and then I've got my water and my small bottle of water, and I mix it in here. I only mix a really small amount, like a teaspoon up at a time, because Smalti takes time and I work slowly, so I don't want to overmix it. That's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and keep an eye out. I post all of these in the announcements, all of my live videos, and I also post on my YouTube channel. So Mosaic Mentoring on YouTube. That's it. Have a great day, guys.